Hello my dear students, this is Shilpi Saxena. Welcome to my channel Learning Hub. So today we will move ahead with Python libraries, in which there will be quick recap of what is package, and after that I'll just introduce init function, and then we'll create a package, and finally we are going to import it. So I'm going to start with what is a package. Already I have explained in my previous video. If you don't remember, please watch my last video. So package, just a quick recap. Basically, function, when we divide a program into small parts, each sub program is known as function. All the Python file which have Python code, you are saving it with extension py, is known as module. Suppose I am a student of class 12th and I have a teacher, and teacher has created a folder of class 12th, and in which she has created all the folders of individual folder of students. In that case, each and every folder of a student is known as package. I shifted all my programs to my folder. That folder is known as package. And the main folder, that is of class 12th, is known as libraries. So basically we can say that Python package and library is a word that can be used interchangeably. There is no major difference between the two. You can say that package is a part of library. So now we will go ahead with init function. See, init function is not in your syllabus, but just to know, to create a package, we will use this function, you will use this file, so it is mandatory for you to understand what is this init. It is basically used function. This function is basically used with classes and objects. Class is a combination encapsulation of all the instances and functions, modules. Functions are, do you know very well what is function? Instances are basically a variables. When variables are defined inside the class, it is known as instance. We can access these functions, we can access these variables or instances using the object. Object is a variable of type class. Like we are writing x is equal to 4. So x is a variable of type integer. Similarly, object is a variable of type class. To explain it more nicely, I will take one example. I have written a program. I'll show you the program of small program of a class. See, I have this example. Class is a keyword. A is the name of class. This is user defined name. Def means two functions are defined. One is to display and one is init function. This init function with double, this has double underscore. This init function, you see, all the functions we have to call. This init function we don't have to call. This is called implicitly when the object is defined. The program execution starts from here. Here we have defined the object. This is the method by which we can define any object. Object O1 is equal to A23. This will implicitly call this init function. And 2 will go to A and 3 will go to B. Now, what is this self? Self represents the object which is calling this particular function. In each and every functions, we have used self. Self means the object which is accessing this function. A class can have multiple objects, and each and every object can have different value in its instance. So, this self can be used to self helps us to differentiate between the different instances. So program start executing from here. O1 is equal to A23. This will initialize the instance. You can see wherever self we are using, it means it's a instance. Wherever we are not using, it's a local variable. So after that, O1.display, we have called this O1.display. It will display the these values. A is equal to, or you can write x is equal to y, x is equal to self.x and y is equal to self.y. I'll run this program. So you can see the output. Y is x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 3. This is the output. So basically the init function is a function which is called implicitly whenever we are creating the object. So now we will go to creating a package. When you want to create a package, first of all you have to identify the structure. You have to finalize the structure of your package. Package means folder and subfolder you want to create, or directly in folder you want to keep all the files. Suppose I'll take one example, like suppose I have a folder, I want to convert it into a package. Suppose this is my main folder, I want to convert, suppose functions folder is there, I want to convert it into a package. So what we will do, first of all we will create a new file. I'll open a new file. And save it with the name in this function. You can see this in functions only. I have to save with the name init.py. If you will not use, then also it will be saved as init.py. You can see here, this is the file init.py. This is mandatory. Now this why we are using this file? See, init.py file is usually empty file when we are creating the package. It is used when the Python script need to look down into the hierarchical level. The existence of init file will lead the program flow. If init file is not there, it will generate package not found error. So init file is mandatory. Basically it is used to trigger the import statement. So see, packages are basically of two types, regular package and namespace package. Regular packages are those packages which have init file. So what happens, this package, whenever regular package is imported, when we will convert this function into a regular package, whenever it is imported, this init.py file is implicitly executed. I told you that init file, init function is implicitly executed. Similarly, init file is implicitly executed, and the object it defines means all the files, all the modules it defines are bound to the namespace. So it will create a namespace for that, that is packages namespace. This is the regular package which we will be learning, and another type of package is namespace package, which is in which init file is not there, that is namespace package. So we will be learning regular package. Once you are done with it, just close it, and then you can go to the interactive mode. So in this interactive mode you have to import system module, import this. This is a module which will help you to locate the site packages. Site packages are the packages which are installed by default when you set up your Python. So these packages contains all the predefined modules which you don't have to install. So import sys. After that you have to write print sys.path. So it will give the path of all the modules in here, all the folders here. So you can see here site packages, you can see the site packages. So you can see all the folders which are there in Python. It will give the location of that particular folder. So you have to look for the site packages. This is the location. Fine. Now what you are going to do is you have to go to this, open the Explorer, and then you can locate this site packages, that is C drive, then users, then del, then app data, then local, then programs, then python library, and site packages, this one. So site packages, so here you have to copy that particular folder. See, I have already copied here functions. This is a folder. Now this function will become a package. So now you can use it as package. Suppose if you want to import it. See, if I want to import any function. See, function is a package. And it has a factorial named function and as lib. This I have used. If you want, you can skip it. In that case, you have to use this whole name. Functions.factorial. Here I have used as lib. So in this folder we have a module of name factorial which have a function factorial. So I'm using that particular function. I'll run this file, enter a number, suppose 5. You can see you can calculate the factorial. So if you want, you can see here import functions. You can use in interactive mode functions, you can import it. And I'll show you, suppose there is any other folder which is not converted to package, you will not be able to use them. See, functions I have already converted into package. Suppose loops is there, I want to import it. So import loops, so I'll not be able to import it. So in this way you can create a folder and convert it into package, and you can import the package in this way. So I hope you understood the concept, and it is very easy to create a package. Please try this. If you like this video, please like and subscribe and hit the bell icon. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.